Hi everyone, hope you're doing well from wherever you're watching this channel, depending on your time zone. Now, we know what William Ruto has been able to do anytime he do an appointment. When he give you a job, what follows next? Of course, yesterday, the new team of CSS took an oath of office, and therefore Ruto has a full new team to help him in governance. You know what is going to follow? It is going to be party after party. The next move is homecoming. And homecoming is going to happen to all CSS apart from yule mwenye alibaki Musalia Mudavadi. The whole 19, kuanzia kwa kina Opiyo Wandayi, kuenda kwa kina John Mbadi, kuenda kwa kina Oparanya, kuenda kwa kina Joho, especially is going to focus kwa hao sana and the rest, akina Kipchumba Murkomen. There's going to be homecoming for each and every CS who has been reappointed or those who have been appointed kwa mara ya kwanza. So that is the new politics that Ruto is going to play across this country. Because remember, even on the first day, when he just did the nomination before they got through vetting, already Ruto was in Mombasa, you know, celebrating Joho. Already he was all over. So we expect this team to move across watakuja huku western, waende coast, waende Mount Kenya, waende Rift Valley, wakuwe everywhere. So that is the next politics that they are going to play. But before they go to that, someone is trying to block them. Someone is trying to stop him. Someone is trying to delay him, because you will not go to celebrate someone when he has a case, you know, trying to stop his appointment. Because as we wake up today, the Kenyan Human Rights Commission has filed a petition in court to remove newly appointed CSS. The CSS took oath of office already. The ground for filing the petition is on a vetting process that approved this CSS. And according to the petition, that process lacked adequate public participation. Hiyo ndio wanaeka hapo. Public participation. So, kuna wengine wanarudiwa tu kwa ile first petition walikuwa nayo. Number two, the issue of integrity. Integrity concerns. If you use an example, the cooperative CS Wycliffe Oparanya, he has existing case with the Ethic and Anti-Corruption Commission, ESCC. So such a case in point, it also raises many issues. And it's not alone. Kuna wengine wako na integrity issues. Wengi sana. Kiongea mambo yake na Kipchumba Murkomen, kuja watu kama wale wameserve in other areas, kama watu wale wamekuwa reappointed. So this petition is likely to disrupt the planned ground running following the wave of disruption by the Gen Zs who have been leading the anti-government protest. Because after the appointment, as I said in the beginning, Ruto wanted to hit ground running. Akianza na siasa, populist politics. Sababu hawa wajamaa wamechaguliwa kufanya kazi, lakini kile kitu ataweka mbele zaidi, it is going to be about politics. You look at the big name that made it back to the cabinet, and there are a lot of concerns being raised. People like Sopian Tuya, CS Defense, Alice Wahome, this is a name that made back, Land, Kipchumba Murkomen, Youth and Sports, Davis Chirchir, Roads and Transport, Salim Vuria, Investment and Trade, Rebecca Miano, Tourism, Did I say Environment, that the list, these are individuals who served in the previous cabinet. Walifutwa kwa nini? Na mbona wanaajiriwa? How have they been spending? Those are some of the questions that will be answered in court. So, as these guys go ahead to celebrate, like what I've seen, like, you know, Paranya, they are already celebrating. I've seen Kipchumba Murkomen is dancing. It is not yet over. Mambo ya kesi ipo. That there was not enough time to have public participation for people to give their views on these names. Ile participation imeonekana pale ni ya parliament. What about the public? Was there enough time for people to come and give their views about these people? We never saw serious town hall meetings discussing the conduct of these people who were nominated. Mimi sikuona serious public participation. Where was the county, where was the meetings held? Ilikuwa wapi? Tulikuwa tunangojea town hall meetings. Watu walete maneno yao, waseme Kipchumba Murkomen ako sawa, mambo ya kuuza airport imefikia wapi? Kama he was not able to solve the issue of leaking roofs at the JKIA, how do you trust him to lead the youth in the sports? How do you trust him? So, because of that, the petition is here. Of course, this means that these individuals have to prepare for a defense in the court. See, it wako free sasa kazi imeanza mambo yako sawa, hapana. They have to prepare for a defense to go and talk about the issue of integrity. How, what, especially if you have served as a governor, akina John and the rest, there's no way they will lack a case to do with corruption in court or mismanagement of public resources. So the issue of integrity comes in. Hakuna vile wataruka hiyo. So we are here. It is not yet over. The struggles continue. But we know the regime is so much determined. They can pass what they want to pass. Yes, to stop them through the court is not easy, because we know again our courts are compromised. They keep on also intimidating them. They will have their way, but it is going to be delayed if need be. Sababu tumekuwa hapa mambo ya chief administrative secretaries CAS. Hey, now I'm a part of, you know, a bombshell of their lives. There has been allegations that these people were receiving a salary after Ruto did the appointments. Yes, they were not actively working, but there has been allegations they have been in the office, walikuwa kwa office wameka, na wakakuwa na mshahara. Chini ya maji. Now, how wako hapa? We know the case will go on, eh? But you will see them in the office, getting salary, sitting in those offices, and running the affairs of those offices. Hapo ndio kuna impunity of the highest order. Sababu kwa inchi nzuri, you keep aside, mambo yamaliza kama ni case. Ruto has never come back to the public to explain why the big names that were in previous government made it back. Atuambia kwa nini alifuta Aden Duale na akaona haja gani ya kumrudisha. He did not engage public to tell them, but just doing silently. And he is employing people into public office. Is your office ya Ruto ya private? Apana. They are paid by taxpayers' money. They will serve in that capacity. and the Kenyans will be waiting for them to deliver. But it seems public was not consulted properly. So tumefika hapo, mambo ya kukimbia na kusema sumeona nimepea nani kazi fulani fulani, yamesimamishwa kwa muda. I don't know your views, but let us put it in the comment section to continue with this discussion. Thank you so much and see you in our next video.